Good evening, everyone. We certainly thank God for the privilege of just being alive and his support and concern for us, watching over us and supplying all of our need. We give honor to him, first of all, for just being a kind and merciful and gracious God to all of our ministers and officers of the church, to our esteemed First Lady, and to all of you who have tuned in. We certainly thank God for the privilege and opportunity to be able to share with you at the beginning of our dramatic presentation of the Gospel by the Drama Ministry. We're living in very difficult and challenging times now, and unusual things are going on, and life has been disrupted as we normally would live it. And I'm frankly grateful and somewhat surprised, really, that the Drama Ministry was able to put on a production this year. This is a very tremendous thing that they're doing. And I want to commend them for their innovation and their commitment and dedication to presenting the gospel through dramatization and doing all that they can and all that they have done for us to have a Christmas production. I mean, this was far and beyond what I expected. I really didn't expect us to be able to have a Drama Ministry Christmas production this year, but the commitment and dedication from this ministry just shocked me. And not only that, but it also encouraged me. And I was very pleased at the effort that you all have made to come up with a production, however you're going to be able to do it through the technology that is available and all the work that you put into it and all the innovative thought that went into this. We are very pleased, and I want to commend you all for your efforts and those of you who are participating and the leaders of the ministry and everyone involved. You've done a wonderful job, and we're looking forward to your presentation. I understand that some private homes were made available for certain scenes, and that in itself is a tremendous effort to see that this ministry is able to carry on and do the things that God has ordained and given us privilege to do in terms of having a drama ministry that would present the gospel in this form. And so I really want to thank you and commend you all for your concerted effort and for all that you've done to make this a reality. And I'm sure that all of us are going to enjoy it. We're looking forward to it with high expectations, and it's already beyond anything that I would have thought could possibly happen, but you did it. And so we're looking forward to hearing and seeing what you have come up with and what God has given you the ability and insight and strength and enablement to make possible through this drama ministry. And so we're just going to, first of all, I want to pray before we conclude this presentation in terms of my talking with you. I want to pray for the outcome and support of the ministry by everyone. I want all of our members to tune in and make sure that you take part in this, because this took great effort. And I know God is going to bless us, and we're just going to have a tremendous outpouring of love and tremendous outpouring of skill and energy put into this by those who are involved in it, and I'm just looking forward to it. And so after prayer, we're going to get ready to take part in the Great I Am for such a time as this. And I think the theme of the presentation speaks to the fact that even though we're having difficult times, God is still God, and he's still involved, and we want to see how that message come through. Amen. God bless you, and the Lord keep you. Let us bow in prayer. Father, we come in Jesus' name, and God, we thank you and praise you for your blessing upon us. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for this ministry and the participants thereof, the leaders of it, and all that they've done, God, to make this presentation possible. We pray for each participant and everyone involved and all of our members that this God will encourage us and will speak to our hearts and minds as a revelation that has come from God through dramatic presentation. Let it be your will, Father, that this will encourage us and to remind us that if we put our trust in God, no matter what is going on and what that time or period of time or conditions we're living in, you're still God. And we want that message to come through, Lord. And so we thank you for it, and we claim it all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I am cold, I have been chosen. good game. You show some skills out there, man. What's been going on with that?
Yeah, I'm gonna be a professional basketball player like LeBron James and Michael Jordan and all those other guys.
But you know what? World leading superheroes, even the Batmans, Spider-Man, Superman, Incredible Hulk, Wonder Woman, even Mighty Mouse. Oh, they can't compare to the great I Am. Listen, now's the time to trust and obey and believe in the creator of the universe, God Almighty. Now choose you today, this day, not to focus on cartoon characters, action figures, entertainers, movie stars, or even athletes, especially politicians.
There's a rumor going around that a new superhero is coming to Earth. They say that he is coming to save the world and that he received his power from the Father for such a time as this. Santa Claus, Christmas trees, twinkling lights, and even Rudolph's red nose cannot overshadow Jesus or the Word of God.
You preach it, my man. Good job, good job. Let's go.
The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy.
Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1 and 2 Samuel, 1 and 2 Kings.
1 and 2 Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, and Esther.
B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
Job.
Psalms.
Proverbs.
Ecclesiastes.
Song of Solomon.
Isaiah.
Jeremiah.
Lamentations.
Ezekiel.
Daniel.
Bible. Basic instructions before leaving Earth.
The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
Glenn, what are you doing?
I'm sorry, Mom, I'm just really excited. I wanted the third since you said the book's in the Bible.
You know what, Glenn? There is. Come on, kids. Let me bring your attention to the 28th book of the Bible.
Oh, Ma, doesn't that start with Hosea?
Yes, and then there's Hope. There's Joel. There's Amos. There's Obadiah. There's Jonah. There's Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah.
Oh, Mom, isn't there Malachi?
There is. That is Malachi.
Wow, there's so many books in the Bible. I can't wait to read them all.
Come on, G, let's go ahead and start reading now.
Yay!
B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. He is the truth, the light,
still is in. There is no place that you can look and not see Jesus. He is everywhere. He is everything. He goes before all things, and in him all things hold together. On that note, thank you for joining our Father's business. Your understanding of our Father's instructions manual will be your next assessment. You may now post your research cards to the New Testament Fence of Protection.
In the book of 1 Timothy, he is your faith. In the book of 2 Timothy, he is your stability. In the book of Titus, he is the truth.
Your benefactor. In the book of Hebrews, he is your perfection. In the book of James, he is the power behind your faith.
In the book of 1 Peter, he is your example. In the book of 2 Peter, he is your purity. In the book of 1 John, he is your light.
In the book of 2 John, he is your partner. In the book of 3 John, he is your motivation. In the book of Jude, he is the foundation of your faith.
In the book of Revelations, he is your coming king.
Welcome to our Father's kingdom building business. Are you ready for that FB chant?
Yeah!
Break it down now.
Give me a B. Give me a I. Give me a B. Give me a L. Give me a E.
You got your B, you got your I, you got your B, you got your L, you got your E. Now what?
The B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. He sparkled the dark with light. In his might, he filled the earth with water, the sky with clouds. On dry ground, he created the trees, flowers, and weeds. Divided day from night. The birds and bees given to flight. The fish, big and small, navigated ponds, oceans, rivers, and all. Then he created the beast of the field to roam as willed. And he looked around and said, "It is good, all good." Somber, lonesome, standing between night and day, yet kneeling over a mound of clay. Postured in his image of love and hope, he formed man. Then inhaling and then exhaling as never before, man became a living soul, made master over land and sea, to be fruitful, to multiply, but not to eat from that tree. The perfect man, formed in the master's hand, did not, could not follow one command. Intrigued to follow, not lead, he committed an infamous deed, bringing death to the earth, only to be remedied with the Savior's death.
Who would have thought that Abram, the lion, would be listed in the lineage of Jesus, the Messiah? But one can never determine his worth. God told me that he would make me into a great nation, that my name will be great, and I will be blessed so that I can exemplify divine blessings and be extremely fruitful, a great nation that kings will descend from. And he did it. At 100 years old, we had the promised child, Isaac. I had learned to put my trust in God because I knew he was a man of his word. I put my faith in God and put the promised son on the altar. But God, hallelujah, had a ram in the bush. Though my faith was tested, it never faded. I am the spiritual father of all those that put their faith in the one true God. So it is through me and my descendants that the Savior of the world has come for such a time as this.
Do you believe the report? Do you see the Lord in this? A plant growing in dry ground? Nothing special about him. Nothing to draw us to him. You despised him, pushed him away. Do you realize he tolerated your pain and suffering? And you won't even look at him like he was nothing. Look, he endured your suffering and pain, and you thought it was his father, punishment that his father sent by God. But he was wounded for your transgression. He was bruised for your iniquities. And the chastisement of your peace was upon him. And with his stripes, you were healed. He committed no sin. Yet the Father offered him for the sins of men. He willingly gave his life for your sin. He took on the sin of all men and prayed that the Father would forgive us for such a time as this.
Thank you.
happened this way. When I, his mother Mary, was engaged to Joseph, before we came together, I was impregnated by the Holy Ghost. And Joseph, being a just man and not willing to make me a public example, thought to put me away privately. But then the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and told him not to be afraid, that the child was of the Holy Ghost, and that I would have a son, and he was to name him Jesus, for he would save our people from their sins. Joseph did as the angel told him. He married me, and he named our son Jesus, the great I Am.
That night, the stars shone brighter than ever. Even though people scurried around, there was stillness everywhere, no vacancies posted all over town. Drawn to Bethlehem to be assessed, the Christ child transitioning to be born, while Mary begged to lie down and rest. Their only lauding animal barn. The animals mourned, the angels sang, glory to the newborn king, while peace on earth, and the shepherds in the field to the manger. Where the Savior lied to go tell it on the mountain, that a Savior is born for such a day as this.
Jesus Christ, the most precious gift ever given, Jesus the Savior, he will save us from the guilt of sin by cleansing us with his own atoning blood. He will save us from the dominion of sin by putting in our hearts his sanctifying spirit. He saves us from the presence of sin when he takes us out of this world to rest with him. He will save us from all of the consequences of sin when he shall give us a glorious body at the last day. Well, there is salvation in no one else. God has given no other name under heaven by which we must be saved. Jesus, the great I Am. For such a time as this. Hallelujah! 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
yourself. He can do anything. Look what he did for Daniel and the lion's den. Look what he did for the three boo-boo boys. God can do anything. Just try God. He can do anything.
God's got the power. Yes, he's got the power.
God's got the power.
God's got the power. Yes, he's got the power.
He got it all in his hands.
God's got the power.
Just try Jesus.
Yes, he's got the power.
God's got the power.
God's got the power. Yes, he's got the power.
You make one step.
God's got the power. Yes, he's got the power.
Just try God.
God's got the power. Yes, he's got the power.
God's got the power.
God's got the power.
All in his hands.
Yes, he's got the power.
God's got the power.
God's got the power. Yes, he's got the power. God's got the power. Yes, he's got the power. God's got the power.
For such a time as this, I am the Good Shepherd. I am the light of the world. I am the door. I am the bread of life. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. I am that I am. I am the great I am.
I am the door, I am the good news to the bound and the poor. I am the righteous one, I am the Lamb. I am the ram in the bush for Abraham, and I am the ultimate sacrifice for sin. I am your redeemer, the beginning and the end. Messiah.
after performing miracle after miracle, from turning water into wine, from healing the sick, from raising the dead, from feeding the hungry, yet he was still betrayed and denied by his friends. He was wounded for your transgressions. He was bruised for your iniquities. But the chastised peace of you was upon him, and with his stripes you are healed. He was verbally, mentally, and physically abused. Yet he paid the ultimate price, a sinless life for sinful people. He was found guilty in order to be killed on a rugged cross. But with all great humility, he died so that you and I may live. Oh, but glory be to God. After 3 days in the tomb, he arose. The tomb was found empty, as he had told his disciples it would be. The grave could not hold him, and now he is in heaven, sitting on the right side of his Father, interceding for you and for I. At such a time as this,
if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. It's for the with the heart one believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confesses unto salvation. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I am he that liveth that was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And have the keys to death and of hell. And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give to every man according to his work.
Chosen, and I am sent in Jesus' name. You go before me, your spirit guides me, your word my lamp that lights the way.
For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. The great I am for such a time as this.
You are great, yes, you are Holy One. Walked upon the sea, raised the dead. Reign in majesty, mighty God. Everything written about you is great. You are great, yes, you are.
You are great.
You are great.
You are great.
You are great.
Yes, sir.
Woo!
Yeah. Hallelujah. Here we go.
Lord, I lift the name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises.
Yeah.
I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
Such a time.